Famous computer scientist once said there are really only two hard problems in computer science. One is cache coherence, and if you want to learn more about that, take a class on hardware. The second is naming, and naming is equally problematic on the internet. One of the things that makes internet naming so hard is that the internet is fundamentally a network of computers that are talking to each other, and computers like certain types of names. For example, computers really appreciate numbers. But the internet has to be useful to humans. If the internet forced you to use all of the computer names that the computers are actually using when they talk to each other, it'd be very difficult to use. Humans like Amazon.com, computers like 128.205.32.4. So how do we reconcile those two things? There's a couple of strategies that we employ online, typically when we talk about internet naming. Two of the most important are translation. So taking human-readable names and translating them somehow into a name that's more useful to a computer. That's primarily used when we translate domain names to IP addresses. The second strategy behind naming online is interesting, and it's just convention. So there are sort of common agreements about what certain numbers mean. For example, port 80. Port 80 is the port that you use to connect to an unsecured web server. So when you browse online, your web server is assuming that when you type something into the address bar, it can contact a server at that IP address on port 80. That convention is something that we've just sort of established within the networking community, and as long as everybody follows it, it works. So that's another strategy. Naming on the internet is also a distributed enterprise. So both IP addresses and host names, the responsibilities for actually assigning those and sort of dealing with the assignments are distributed to lots of different entities. When it comes to IP addresses, the addresses are sort of distributed to autonomous systems that can then allocate them internally. When it comes to domain names, the domain name system assigns sort of top-level maintainers to each of the .com, .org, .edu sort of namespaces, and they're in charge of handing out names within their assigned areas. So naming online, a couple different approaches, you know, a very interesting problem. There's a lot of fun things to talk about, some sort of deep computer science principles in terms of translation and convention. And overall, not necessarily a solved problem, but a problem that we've made quite a bit of progress in addressing. So a famous computer scientist once said, there are only two hard...